Welcome to Dodgers Daily. I'm Casey Porter. I'm so glad that you decided to tune in. We are downtown Tulsa, Oklahoma, the beautiful One Oak Field. We're joined by a very special guest, right-handed reliever in the Dodgers organization, Kevin Gowdy joins. So, Kevin, thank you so much.
Thanks for having me on.
Okay, first of all, when I started, you know, kind of looking up your story, it had to be that you and Trevor Betancourt had to be really good friends.
Right.
Both Santa Barbara area, both drafted in 2016. Both by the Phillies, both came to the Dodgers last year.
We actually didn't know each other when I was in high school and he was in college, and then got to the Phillies and he was my first roommate at pro ball. So definitely became really good friends there and have been great friends since. And I mean, probably lifetime friends with him, you know. I'll go to his wedding in next January. So really, really excited to be playing with Trevor and have him, you know, as a good friend.
You know you're good friends with Trevor whenever, after you leave for a couple days, his dog whimpers whenever you're not around.
Right. Yeah, Bagel. It's been awesome living with Bagel. Like, even if you have, like, a bad outing or bad day or whatever, you go home and she's just excited to see you. So, definitely a morale booster, I'd say.
Obviously, the Phillies, talk about your time with them. Then you got traded in 2021. So
right.
Talk about that.
Right. Yeah, it was definitely pretty emotional getting traded just because I had been through Tommy John with the Phillies, had rehabbed, been around for a few years with them, so I had some really special relationships. And getting traded was tough, you know, it was a new chapter and I was really excited about it. But at the same time, it was tough saying goodbye to some of those guys. But I mean, I'm super grateful for them drafting me, taking the chance on me and, you know, helping me develop while I was with them.
So you had chosen UCLA out of high school.
Right.
Obviously, second round, that's a pretty easy decision.
Right.
So take us through your decision to choose UCLA. Did you know Nick Mastrini? I know he was at UCLA during that time.
Actually, didn't know him at all. No, he was a few years younger than me. But yeah, I mean, it was close to home, really good program. John Savage, I think, is really good with pitching development.
Yeah.
And so it was an easy decision for me. And I was actually, I mean, I figured there was a good chance with the draft of going where I wanted to, but I was ready to go to school, you know, and then draft just kind of ended up working out how I wanted it to, and the rest is history from there.
You've always had a long, tall, lanky body, which has been an advantage for you. And you've always had the big right arm. We've always known that. But hey, you're known for a guy that's way more than just the right arm. I mean, you're a guy that'll pitch backwards. You're a guy that really is known as being able to just pitch. So somebody had to have taught you that along the way.
Right. Yeah, it's all started with Tom Myers. He was he's actually a scout with the Dodgers now.
Yeah.
He was the pitching coach out at UCSB when I was growing up, and so started going to lessons with him when I was 8 or 9 years old, and really just gave me a solid foundation of mechanics and using my body the right way, and even stuff like long tossing, you know. So that was a huge start for me and kind of just a really solid foundation to build off and just keep going with.
Okay, so anytime you get to the position you're in, you've had the amount of success you've had, there's been a whole village of people that have helped you get here, so this is your chance to say thank you.
For sure. Yeah, absolutely. I mean, Tom Myers, the workers back at Santa Barbara High School, all the coaches with the Phillies, coached with the Rangers, Dodgers. I mean, like you said, it takes a village, and I couldn't go through each individual person, but there's been a ton of people who I wouldn't be here without. So wanted to thank all of them, and they know who they are.
Yeah, no doubt. Okay, so you mentioned the Dodgers. Here you are. You're with the Drillers at the AA level. You were a free agent after, you know, during the offseason. You chose the Dodgers, so why the Dodgers?
They're the best with player development. I mean, it's funny, like, even on other teams, like, you hear stories of, like, how they take care of their guys, how good they are with player development. And so when I threw for them in early January and they offered me a one-year deal and I jumped right at it. I mean, I was really excited to get on board with it.
Yeah, so
and have loved it so far.
So everything you heard about the Dodgers development?
It's all true.
Yeah.
It's all true, yeah. I think they're the best in the business at it.
So, you know, hey, this Drillers team, I mean, you got one arm after the other that's, I know you're approaching 100. I mean, there's several arms that are the exact same way. What's it like getting to pitch with such a great pitching staff?
With such a great pitching staff?
Yeah.
I mean, it's such a good competition between us all. You know, we're all friends off the field and on the field too, obviously. But, like you'll see one guy start climbing the velo and it's like, hey, I want to do that. You know, or like one guy's striking everybody out and it's like, I want to do that. You definitely feel that with the starters too, you know, like, one guy will go out and throw 6 shutouts, and the next guy wants to go throw 7 shutouts. So, such a healthy competition between everybody, you know, and we're all competing with each other every day.
Can you tell me about your experience in Japan?
Yeah, it was incredible, you know, especially at such a young age. It was so cool, like, playing different countries and, like, seeing each style, each country's kind of style of play, you know, like the differences between like a Japan versus Mexico or like a Cuba versus Australia, you know, like seeing how different parts of the world play baseball. And we ended up winning gold, which was one of my best and most memorable experiences in baseball, for sure.
So you got to go to Japan, correct?
Went to Japan, Osaka.
Was that your first time ever overseas?
I had been to London when I was like maybe 9 or 10, just as like a family kind of vacation thing. But first time for baseball,
So that's really cool.
It is.
So you've had all these great experiences. You know, you get this wonderful high school career. You had the offer at UCLA. You know, you're a second round draft pick. You've been a professional forever. So you would know. Okay, what things do you think you're good at? Good enough at right now to be a system maker?
I think the sinker has been huge for me. I actually just picked it up maybe a month ago. Had always been a four-seam guy, and the metrics on my four-seam weren't great, so like I had to be painting it at the top of the zone, and I think if I'd missed out in the zone, I'd get hit. So we were throwing a touch and feel one day, and Dinick was like, hey, have you ever thrown a sinker? And I was like, I've played around with one, but had never thrown in a game or anything. And we started throwing a few. We both liked where it was at, and so I took it into the game that night, and it's been a huge pitch for me so far. The velo is climbing up on it, so hopefully just keep developing that and getting guys up.
Yep. Okay, so what things do you think you need to continue to work on, or one thing the most?
Yeah, definitely the cutter, which I also picked up probably about a few weeks, a month ago. The slider's been there for me this year, but with the cutter, just keep working on keeping grip with it and commanding it, and I think that's going to help everything a lot.
Okay, message for kids, man. I mean, you've got a great story. You've been in professional baseball for a while, so what's your message for kids and how they can become like you?
100%. I mean, I would say, as cliche as it sounds, never give up on your dream and what you're going for. You know, there's going to be adversity no matter where you go, where you're playing, but if you want it bad enough, you'll find a way to just keep going and keep working and work until you get there.
Awesome deal. Kevin, thank you so much. I know you're very busy, so thank you so much for your time. It's been a joy getting to meet you and watch you pitch.
Absolutely, man. I appreciate that.
Okay, thank you.